Welcome to Concerning Pipers, a show concerning all things pipes and tobacco. I'm your host, Mike.
And I'm Joe.
Hey, Joe. Welcome, man. How are you?
Doing well. How you doing?
I'm good, man. What you smoking it on? What you smoking it in?
The Virginia Cream from GL Peace. And I'm smoking it in my Finsbury imported briar. And it is delicious. What are you smoking?
Excellent. I am smoking GLP's six pits. So we're both smoking some peas blends. This is a vapor blend from 2015. And it's just excellent stuff, man. Stone fruit and tangy and just dark and delicious. So, and I'm smoking it. It's Holly Artisan Pipe that I got from Pipe Dreams PDX on Instagram. Cool dude. So yeah, we're here because we got challenged by Nick Chain Smoker on TikTok. He challenged us to come together to make some informational pipe smoking videos. So it's going to be a series of three. And this first one is going to be centered around the history of pipes and pipe smoking materials and how it all began. So we're going to get into it. So take a trip back in time with us as we dive deeper into the history of pipe smoking. Back in the day when pipe smoking was at its prime, your traditional brick and mortar shop looked like this. Now, most tobacco shops look like this. Today, sales of pipes and pipe tobacco are minuscule compared with other forms of tobacco consumption. Some studies place pipe smoking down around 80% over the past decade. Even Dunhill, an iconic British pipe manufacturer famous for putting a white dot on its pipes, is getting out of the business, taking their cigar trade with them. But there's still a certain elegance to enjoying a bowl of pipe tobacco and having no small amount of skill in keeping it lit. There's a whole history to it.
So the first smoking pipe was made from copper, and it comes from Egyptian culture dating back to 2000 BC, found buried in tombs. And it's unclear if it was used ceremonial or recreationally. But Herodotus, I guess, known as the father of history, noted Iranian tribes smoking burning leaves in 500 BC. In 1500 BC, tobacco was used by Native Americans, mainly for sacred religious practices. The peace pipe was used as part of reconciling conflicts between rival tribes. And then later, Christopher Columbus found native smoking pipes and took samples of the tobacco back to Europe with him. Pipe smoking in Europe took off in the 16th century when Jean Nicot, after whom nicotine is named, made tobacco popular in France after a stint as ambassador to Portugal, where he was convinced of the medicinal values of tobacco leaves. Nicot took tobacco in both leaf and snuff form back to France, making pipe smoking the first popular method of consuming tobacco.
Pipes in Europe were first made of chalk and clay. They were relatively inexpensive and easy to produce. In 1720, meerschaum pipes made of soft, white, clay-like substance became popular due to the artistic carvings of the pipes with long stems. They drew well, but became intensely hot, and the smoker would have to hold them by the stem. Touching the bowl of the pipe would burn your fingers. It took about 100 years for meerschaum to fall off the top of the ladder, yielding mostly to pipes made of briar wood, which holds to this day.
So now briar is used, and traditionally best for a combination of reasons. First of all, it is tough enough to withstand the heat of burning tobacco, which commonly reaches 700 degrees Fahrenheit, and under hard puffing may go much higher. Secondly, it has a grain structure that allows it to absorb moisture originally contained in tobacco and vaporized during combustion. but that starts condensing as soon as it is drawn away from the combustion zone into cooler areas of the pipe, the stem, and the mouthpiece. This absorption of moisture enables a drier smoke, much prized by those who truly enjoy the taste of tobacco.
Excellent. Welcome back. Appreciate you guys tuning in to our history lesson there. So Joe, you want to talk a little bit about, industry impact that the briar, going from meerschaum to briar there had on, pipe manufacturing?
The impact. Well, it's an easier to get material than, it's not, but it made it from a ceramic artisan thing to a word carving artisan thing. The craftsmanship is way different.
Yeah,
from, say, making a mug, a clay mug or clay pipe to a briar pipe.
Right. I think it, I mean, I know that, some briar is easier to obtain than others. I mean, you've got your newer briar burls that are, I mean, your younger, I should say, briar burls that are easier to obtain now.
Mm-hmm.
Your older briar burls, which, the longer the briar is in the ground, the older it is, the better the grain is going to be.
Yeah.
Those are harder to find. So, but I think that shifting to briar altogether, especially during that time, made pipes more accessible to the everyday working man. And yeah, I think that really led to the boom of pipe smoking that we saw.
Mm-hmm. And today. A boom in shape variations and stuff. I think with briar comes a lot of, you come out with the bulldog and the billiard and you get agreed upon shape charts. And people play with it now with freehand styles and stuff. I think it's, cool to see it develop over the decades and centuries.
Right. Yeah, I mean, it really allowed for more artisanal design when it comes to pipe making. Excellent. Well, so that ends the first series, video of this series. That ends the first video of the series. I want to give a shout out to Chainsmoker Nick for challenging us into doing this. It was very fun and informative, and we hope to educate you guys, and we hope to see you guys again for the next one. And I want to give a shout out to Softy Bits. Softy Bits creates a little plastic bit that goes on the end of your stem, and it makes clinching effortless. And remember, if it doesn't say Softy, it's not the real thing. I want to thank you all again for watching. Be sure to check out our Instagram, Concerning Pipers, and be sure to like and subscribe. See y'all next time.
Peace and love.